Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. Last time we took a deep dive into Google's Gemini 2.0 and got really excited about how it can handle pretty much everything, like, you know, text, images, video and voice, all at once and in real time. It's pretty amazing how natural and human-like it feels. We didn't just stop at playing around in Google AI Studio though. We went ahead and built our own chat app based on Google's demo to really show off what this tech can do. In that app, we focused on the development of a chat interface that can accept the human voice and video input, and then asynchronously generate voice or text responses by the high performance and low latency Gemini 2.0 Flash experimental model. This was all achieved by using Google's experimental Multimodal Live API, which is accessible through WebSocket connection. We implemented an intermediate server that handles WebSocket connections with the API, which then forwards the message from and to a front-end client. We had our main code walkthrough on server-side implementation in Python, as it is the key to activate Gemini's Multimodal Live API. Then we also covered the client-side implementation in HTML and JS for real-time voice and video interaction. Let's quickly experience it again. Hey, how are you today?
I'm doing well, thank you for asking. How are you doing today?
I'm very good. So what is this?
It appears you're holding a small, white, square-shaped object. Can you tell me more about it, or what you'd like to know about it?
Could you have a guess? What is this?
Is there something else you'd like to tell me or ask me about?
No, just this one. Can you guess what is this?
Okay. Is there anything specific you'd like to say or ask about this one? You're asking what the white square object is, correct? Unfortunately, I cannot know exactly what it is, but it looks like it could be a charging case for wireless earbuds. Would you like to tell me what it is?
Yes, you are correct.
Okay, so I was right. It is a charging case for wireless earbuds. Is there anything else I can help you with?
So today we are going to dive deeper into a specific extension to make these interactions even more powerful with function calling. Function calling is a critical feature that allows AI assistant like our Gemini-powered app to interact with external systems and APIs. Instead of just generating text or audio, the model can understand the user request, then generate the instructions like parameters required to use a function, and then execute the function. So it effectively involves the Gemini-powered app to become more than just a multimodal chatbot. It transforms it into a powerful agent capable of performing real-world tasks. Most importantly, it allows the agent to be more human-like and interactive. The good news is that the experimental Multimodal Live API of Gemini 2.0 supports the function generation that follows the data schema of its common generative API. So today we will make some interesting improvements to our previous chat app by adding function calls and let it execute it internally and preserve the existing voice and video interaction. For example, imagine a scenario in the movie of Iron Man where you ask the AI assistant Jarvis dim the lights to 30% and set them to warm mode for movie night, or turn on all lights to full brightness with daylight temperature. I need to focus. With function calling, it can actually identify the function to call the control of the lights API and make the change happen in real time. Just perfectly matched what we have seen in the movie. Let's start to build this app. As usual, we should mostly focus on the server-side implementation by the Python language. First, we should install the Google Gen AI library, as well as the WebSockets library, if you haven't done so. In the code, import all the necessary modules and define your Google API key and the model Gemini 2.0 Flash EXP, and create the client by Gen AI client method, and define in the API version as V1 alpha version that include the package of multimodal live API. Then we need to declare the tool function, the set light values that module will be calling. This function does nothing but return the light parameters, including brightness and color temperature from the model request, which are used to verify the call result and the model's response performance. To make Gemini aware of this function, we create a tool set light values as a dictionary that conforms to the required schema, specifying its name, description, parameters, including their type and properties, brightness and color temperature, with a type and description. This schema is the same as the one used in OpenAI's function calling API. Now we need to define the message data flow between the server and Gemini API, and with the data flow that to and from the client. All these are implemented in the function Gemini session handler. This function will be called a new WebSockets connection established. So its argument is the client WebSocket object from the client. After the connection is established, the function will send a config message in the client AIO live connect method to the Gemini live API to set up the response modalities from the client side setting and register the tool set light values into the tools that we just defined, and use this config for the WebSocket connection to the multimodal live API. After that, there are two main data paths to be done in the function. The first one is the data forwarding from the client to Gemini API in the send to Gemini coroutine. And the second is the Gemini processing from Gemini API to client in the receive from Gemini coroutine. So in the first task of send to Gemini pass, the server receives a real-time user input with audio or image data from the client WebSocket, and then repackage it to the Gemini API by using the session send. The session is created by initial connection. So this path has no difference from the previous demo. In the task of receive from Gemini path, the server then starts receiving data from the model using session receive method. Gemini has already received all the input data, including text, audio prompt, or image data, and processes this data through the large language model, then decide to respond with text or audio, or also call a function based on what the user has asked for. The decision is based on the system instruction and the data provided, including input text, audio, and images. So here, I add the first section to determine if the model response is a tool call. If it is, then extract the function call details from the response and execute tool function and get the result. Here, I ask the server to send the result first to the client to display and verify by using client WebSocket send method. Then it will send the result as function response, including name and response details and the call ID to Gemini API. Then the model will continue to generate the final response based on the call result. And the intermediate conversation and final response in text or audio are handled in the data structure of response server content model turn, which include a list of parts or trunks as the same as the previous demo. Please note that the audio data need to be encoded to Base64 format to make it playable as PCM data on the client browser. Two tasks will be running in parallel asynchronously to ensure the real-time interaction. And in the main function, we have async io.future method, which will keep the server running indefinitely. So here we establish the WebSockets at a local host at port 9082. That's all for the server part. And the client side that return in the HTML file, including JavaScript, is exactly the same as the previous video because it just needs to handle the user interface with image capturing and audio recording, as well as text output and audio playback. You can download the code with a PCM processing code file, PCM processor JS, from my GitHub repository listed in the description below. Okay, that's all for the code. Let's run it to see the result. So firstly, let's start the server by running the Python script. Okay, so you see the WebSocket server is running on the localhost 9082. Let's run the client by the command python http.server. Now the HTTP server has also available at port 8000. So let's open it in browser. Hey, I need analysis of this room's brightness.
Okay, I can analyze the brightness. It looks like the room is currently lit, but not very brightly. Would you like me to adjust the brightness?
Yes, please change the brightness to 70% and the color temperature to warm.
Sure, I can do that. I'll set the brightness to 70% and the color temperature to warm.
Could you try set the color temperature to cool?
I can do that. I'll set the color temperature to cool.
Maybe the brightness to 90%.
Okay, I'll adjust the brightness to 90%.
Looks perfect, right? Then let me change a little of this function response to see whether the model can identify that really. So let me uncomment here. Comment this. Now, whatever I told the model to set, the response will always be the light is broken. So that means the setting should not be successfully done. Let's see what the model's response. Let's run again. Hey, could you set the color temperature to warm and the brightness to 90%?
Sure, I will set the color temperature to warm and the brightness to 90%.
What's the result?
Okay, it seems the light is broken.
Oh, it's so bad. Can you try again?
Sure, I can try again. I will set the color temperature to warm and the brightness to 90%. Okay, it seems that the light is still broken.
Okay, looks all the function is working now. This is still just at the beginning. I'm excited to see how you will build your own application with Gemini 2.0 and push the boundaries of what is possible. That's all for today. Thanks for watching.